Well, I think, you know, the first thing to resolve the whole issue of Kosovo is to make Kosovo a member of NATO. That's what I'm, listen, who worked hard to get NATO status for Albania? I did. In fact, look at my interview with, what was he then, President or Prime Minister Berisha. He said to me, Joe, we need your help. This is 1993. Please try to get us into NATO. And I shifted the lobbying to that. Well, we need that for Kosovo today. Once Kosovo is in NATO, then it has the protection of all the NATO members. So I would rather work on that before we did anything with the UN. Because the UN is confused with the Ahtisaari plan, with Resolution 1244. And obviously, we want to get as many states as possible to recognize Kosovo at the UN. But I would spend my time now on hopefully getting Kosovo as a member of NATO, because then we'll be fully protected. Don't forget, we're the ones that brought the U.S. troops to Kosovo. We're the ones that made sure that Erdogan did not take Bondsteel. When I heard that he was trying to do that, I ran to Washington right away, and I met with the chairman of the U.S. Armed Services Committee, and we changed that so that Bondsteel was controlled by American troops. We need American troops there somehow. Not, you know...
Plan to take Bondsteel?
There was. Erdogan wanted it. And I forget who was saying it at that time, that maybe we have too many troops around the world and we have to take some troops out of Kosovo, and maybe we should turn Bondsteel over to Erdogan. This, if you don't remember this, this was within the last 10 years.
Okay, so my last question.
Maybe it wasn't publicized, and maybe I got the message, and I made sure it didn't happen.